Good morning, y'all. Thank y'all for coming this morning to Lawrence County as we showcase summer meals and our school nutrition program. I am Donna Sapp. I'm the school nutrition director for Lawrence County, and I am very fortunate to work with a school board, a superintendent, administrators, principals, teachers, and staff that support school nutrition and support the initiative of feeding kids. We have 77 great people that I get to work with every day that's on our school nutrition staff that made this possible today. We work closely with them because we feel like a hungry kid cannot learn. And so not only do we feed students during the school year, we feed students during the summer. We kicked off our summer meals program on June the 5th, and we feed about 2,000 meals per day since then. So today you'll get to see that. Another part of the school nutrition program, we are advocates of Georgia grown and Georgia agriculture. And today we'll have a Georgia grown meal, where about 30% of that meal is coming from Lawrence County. We'll also, we're showcasing our gardens out front. All of the zinnias and the centerpieces are from our school gardens. So we hope you enjoy. We thank you for being here. And now, without further ado, I'll introduce our Lawrence County Commissioner, a pig farmer, local pig farmer, and a good friend of mine, Mr. Trey Kemp.
I just have to say what a great job Ms. Sapp has done with everything. It looks terrific in here, and her taking this bull by the horns and making this program what it is really a feather in our cap in Lawrence County, and we sure do appreciate her. There's really kind of two Americas going on, one that puts value on price and one that puts value on quality. And the programs that we see today are those that really put all the emphasis on quality. And so I appreciate all the local efforts by the local school board and by local farmers in helping make this happen. On behalf of Lawrence County Commissioners, I do appreciate everybody being here today. Thank y'all.
Lawrence County Schools believes that our school nutrition staff is quite a feather in our cap. We too believe that hungry children cannot learn, and Ms. Sapp and her staff do a great job not only feeding our students but educating them as well. And we have, she has the help, I know, of Mr. Terry Brown with the Young Farmers Group. And they do so much with students about teaching students that food doesn't just come from the grocery store. And we were about to get into a climate where that's exactly what children thought. You had to go to Walmart Superstore or Kroger to pick up your produce and your vegetables. And that's certainly not the case. And that's become a very real part of education in Lawrence County. And we're quite proud of Ms. Sapp and the program that we have going on here. When those students get so excited about eating their own cabbage that they grew, and we're really excited that they're excited. And she goes the great mile to make sure our students have snacks during testing that are healthy and thought-producing. So that's always a good thing. And we do thank her and her staff for that. I'm going to introduce Doug Rome. He is the executive director of the Middle Georgia Community Food Bank. And he is with us today and has a few words for us.
Well, thank you very much. It's an honor to be here. Middle Georgia Community Food Bank, our service area is 24 counties in Middle Georgia, so Lawrence County is part of our service area. And even though I have about 14 nonprofit food pantries that are existing right here in Lawrence County, a lot of what they do really doesn't help the children during the summertime because a lot of the food that they're getting from us obviously are shelf-stable type foods. But when it comes to summertime, these kids that are getting the free and reduced lunch during the school year, they're probably missing as many as 10 meals during the week. So summer meals program are essential for what we're doing. And it's just been amazing the job that Michelle has done in the last 5 years from where the summer meals has started in school nutrition and child nutrition to where it is now with over 2,600 locations during the summertime. So again, it's just an amazing job, and it is essential for doing this. And just how, you know, the texting food to 877-877 is something that is done all over the state and all over the country in a lot of places. So it's something that anyone can know to know where the closest resource is to where they live so that kids can go without missing a meal. I just like to say it's just amazing how the farm to the school is really growing. I know that Bibb County actually won, I think it was a Golden Radish Award for being the top producer of utilizing locally grown fruits and vegetables. So, and I'm not exactly sure where that come from, but I saw that was given to them. But I see that it's definitely going out through the whole state. Again, I'm just proud to be here. whatever resources we can do to make sure that these programs grow. One of the things that we just started doing is our school pantry program we're doing with high schools. We do just locally in about six counties in our service area. We're doing about 3,000 backpacks every single week for kids on the weekends. But now we're seeing that that's mainly just elementary school kids. But we have now seven high school food pantries that we're doing where that way the kids can utilize food to take home to their families. So that way it's less cost on us and they're utilizing foods that are available for the whole family. So hopefully that's something that can grow, especially in Lawrence County. So that way the older students can start to have more resources available to them. I know I only have 5 minutes, so I'll stop now. So I'll go ahead and introduce our next speaker from Bright from the Start. It's Shawnee Drake, the Marketing and Outreach Manager.
Good morning. It's a pleasure to be here today with our partners, including the Georgia Department of Education, the Atlanta Community Food Bank, the Southeast United Dairy Industry Association, stakeholders, and other special invited guests as we celebrate the start of the summer meal season. The Georgia Department of Early Care and Learning administers the Summer Food Service Program, also known as the SFSP, that ensures that children across the state have access to healthy meals and snacks during the summer when school is not in session. Over 60% of children in the state of Georgia, or just under 1.1 million children throughout the state, qualify for and receive free or reduced price meals during the school year. However, during the summer, that resource is no longer available, and many families are left wondering how they will provide their children the nutritious meals that they need to continue to learn, play, and grow. The Summer Food Service Program and the Seamless Summer option that is offered here at Northwest Lawrence Elementary ensure that children have continued access to these healthy and well-balanced meals. 100 sponsors provided over 5.6 million meals at over 1,600 sites throughout the state in 2016. And working together with our partners at the Georgia Department of Education, six targeted counties in the state where there was no meal service in 2015 had at least one meal site last year and fed children in those counties. We are delighted to celebrate the summer meal season with all of our partners and hope for continued growth and partnership. You can help ensure that your community knows about these programs so that children and their families have access to this incredibly important resource. I challenge each person here today to share how to locate summer meals in your community with a local organization, whether it be a church, a grocery store, a park, or another location where families and children frequent. Let them know children in need of healthy meals and snacks can text FOODGA to 877-877. This texting system will provide the three nearest meal sites to the user based on the location information that they provide. Spread the word so that children throughout the state know that these nutritious and well-balanced meals are available to them so that they will be well-nourished during the summer months and will be well-prepared for the coming school year. Again, we appreciate you for being here today. And now I would like to introduce Benjamin Newberry of Donovan Dairy.
Thank you, and I'd like to say on behalf of all the dairymen in the Southeast United Dairy Association, I'm glad to be here this morning to speak on their behalf. And I'm a local dairy farmer, actually, just right outside of Macon in Bibb County, but I'm a fourth-generation dairy farmer. We milk about 100 cows twice a day, and we have been on our farm for a little over 100 years. And so one thing that I wanted to make sure that's important, and it goes not only with dairy farmers, but I'm sure with pig farmers and our row crop farmers as well, that it's usually a family thing. It's something that's passed from generation to generation to generation. And so I'm excited to be here, and I'm excited to support, we're excited to support the summer feeding programs, because we do realize that hunger doesn't take a break just because the kids are out of school. They're going to be kids that are hungry through the summer as well, and so we want them to be healthy when they return to school in the fall. And also, it's a great time for them to fuel up with milk. And you know, milk is something that provides them with calcium, protein, and vitamin D, which are all needed to build strong bones, teeth, and muscles. And we're also proud to be partners with Fuel Up Play 60. It is our school health and wellness program that encourages students to fuel up with nutrient rich foods, and get activity and play for at least 60 minutes. Nutrition is important to fuel your body with the right foods, such as low-fat and fat-free dairy, for example, milk, cheese, and yogurt, but also whole grains, fruits, and vegetables. And physical activity, trying to get 60 minutes of activity in a day, whether through a team sport, walking activity, breaks in school, etc., whatever works for them. Also, fuel up play 60s. Healthy eating and physical activity focus at school will continue through the summer feeding programs like you're participating in today. And so I want to thank you once again for this opportunity on behalf of all of our dairy farmers.
Join Piggly Wiggly in the celebration of our 100th anniversary. And the celebration is spreading throughout our community with a renewed pride in our hometown grocer, Piggly Wiggly. 100 years of great product and great customer service. Piggly Wiggly is where you'll find everything from the freshest in produce to 100% certified Angus beef, the only certified Angus beef dealer in Lawrence County. Piggly Wiggly, down home, down the street. Thanks for joining us in our 100th anniversary celebration.
Hi, I'm Chuck Harwell with the Community Bank of Dublin Lawrence County. We're proud to offer the latest technology in the banking industry. From our teller pods to online services that allow you to manage money and pay your bills all at your fingertips. Our every design has you in mind, right down to our expanded drive-thru for the convenience of larger vehicles. Our banking services surpass any other in town. You'll notice the difference when you walk in our front door. Remember, Community Bank of Dublin Lawrence County, the bank that service built, where common sense banking never goes out of style.
And it's my opportunity now to introduce Misty Friedman, our farmer to school coordinator.
Donna, thank you so much for inviting me to be here today. I'm Misty Friedman. I'm the Farm to School Coordinator for the Georgia Department of Agriculture. So in a nutshell, my whole job is to work with farmers and schools to get more Georgia foods in front of our Georgia students every single day and as much as possible. And I was reading the menu when I ran down here earlier to take a look at the lunch line. I was a school level manager, so I always like to go in and say hey to the ladies that are in there working. And the menu today is 100% Georgia grown. It's either from the ground or it's a value-added Georgia product. And that is so exciting to see. Not only are these meals feeding these kids who are hungry during the summer, but it's impacting not only our Georgia economy, but our local economy as well. Today you'll see foods from three different farms. J&J Farms in Dublin, which provided our tomatoes, Sunrise Farms out of Dudley, which is right here for blackberries, and Tomlinson Farms out of Dublin provided the watermelon today. And what I have found is that when kids realize that it's not from the grocery store, that it's not from, you know, mom and dad, that it's really from a farmer. And I really love when you see those kids connect those dots of, you know what, we drive past that watermelon field every day. And then they can see it right here. And then they go in the grocery store and they see the name there. So it really connects all of these dots. And then you add in the summer when it really is our most bountiful time, and the kids, not only are they being fed, but they're really learning that what goes on around them really impacts their lives on a day-to-day basis. So on behalf of Commissioner Gary Black and the Farm to School efforts here in Georgia, thank you so much for being here, and buy Georgia Grown when you can. And I'm going to introduce Robert McCosh. He's the USDA Program Specialist in Food and Nutrition Services.
Thank you, Misty. I'm Robert McCosh. I'm with USDA in Atlanta, and I just want to thank all of you for your support for our programs. Events such as this and the summer meals feeding programs would be impossible without the support and the partnerships that we see coming together today. USDA is coordinating efforts at the national, state, and local level. to provide quality meals for children during the summer would be impossible without the support of state and local government. It just wouldn't happen. And we know that the low-income children that receive meals during the school year, that is sometimes the only meal and probably the best quality meal that they receive. So this time of year, even though it's a time of vacation for a lot of us, it is also a time of where kids miss school because they miss the food. And so we are really grateful for the support that we see here today from the local government, from the state, the partnerships between Georgia DOE and Georgia DECAL in the seamless summer option and the regular summer food service program. By having the two options, it makes it easier for local school districts and local organizations to even put on this program. And so also the other thing is the growing partnerships with farm to school, so that not only are we enriching their body, but we're also enriching their mind, introducing them to foods that they didn't know about before, that they may have never seen or consumed. We're encouraging fruit and vegetable consumption at the same time. Georgia DOE is increasing, and Georgia DECAL is increasing their summer program, and that is a really good thing, and we do all we can to support them through our contacts with national organizations, state organizations, and regional organizations. But at the same time that we increase, we're also improving quality and with oversight. So not only do we reach more and more children in places where the summer program isn't available, but we also are good stewards with taxpayers' money, and we give the best quality meal that we can at the same time. And so we're really happy to be here on behalf of USDA. Thank you all so much for your support for this program. It's a really crucial program in our feeding programs. And with that, I'll cut it short, and I want to introduce Kathy Peavy. She's the Assistant Director with Georgia Department of Education.
Good morning, good morning. Thank you for the effort you made to stand here and to come here today. It shows that you care about the boys and girls that are in that gymnasium right now, and the boys and girls of Lawrence County. Kudos to the Lawrence County School Nutrition Program and also the Board of Education and the community support. It makes a difference. Of course, we know that during the school year, children come to school, and this is an expectation that they're going to have a quality meal, and they do. But I want to tell you a little story about summer feeding, as that's something that's not always been around. Summer feeding's not been here for years and years and years. Let me share this story from a local school nutrition director that had a bus program, and the bus program would travel out into the community, just like Lawrence County also has. And with that, meals were served at strategic locations where students were located, and they were unable to have the ability to obtain healthy meals during the summertime. During the time, the bus was running late on this particular day. So the staff got into a van to scoot on out to where the location was, because there was an expectation of what time these meals were to come. As the director turned down the dirt road in this community and to serve the meals, knowing to start with they were late, out of all of the homes, some of the homes didn't have windows, some of the homes doors were not attached as they should be. I think you can understand what type of neighborhood this possibly was. Children began to run behind the van as they were approaching because it was late to begin with. As they were driving, there was a child that came out of a home in diapers, no shoes, no shirt, little boy running behind the van. Of course, the director was going slow, knowing that you have to be cautious with this. Stopped, and as the director was getting out of that vehicle, this little child in the diaper, tears, and of course the dust by then, because you're behind on a dirt road, said, "I just want my lunch. I just want my lunch." That's why we're here. That story's real. I was that director. I was the individual driving that van. I know this makes a difference. That changed my life. That changed the life of the staff that was involved in the summer feeding. And I share that with you to give you that thought that this is real. Hunger is real. We're accomplishing something to make a better day for the youth that are going to be our leaders, because we depend on them. Thank you for the opportunity to be here, and I just again appreciate the support that the Lawrence County Board of Education provides to the school nutrition program here in Lawrence County. On behalf of the Georgia Department of Education School Nutrition Program, we welcome your comments, we welcome your support, we welcome hearing from you, because we are here to serve the boys and girls of the counties in Georgia. Thank you so much.
Hello, I'm Amy Duke, proud principal of Northwest Lawrence Elementary School, and we are very excited to host today the School Nutrition Summer Meals Kickoff Program here at our school. I have with me Dr. Kathy Peavy. She is the Assistant State School Nutrition Director for the Georgia Department of Education. Thank you for being at our school today.
Thank you for the invitation.
We are very excited about this opportunity for our students. Can you tell us why you chose Lawrence County for this summer kickoff?
Lawrence County is a county that's dedicated to the growth and the nutrition of the students involved in the school system. And Lawrence County is a perfect example with the school nutrition program throughout the school year of the support from the parents and from everyone involved. And so it carries through into the summertime. And we knew that through the summer program, the Seamless Summer Nutrition Program offered through the Georgia Department of Education, that Lawrence County would succeed in taking care of those students that are out during the summertime. The students that you need to be healthy as they return here to school for you in August.
You're absolutely right, and we are certainly blessed. Donna Sapp is our school nutrition director for Lawrence County. She does a phenomenal job. We have an excellent staff that supports this program, and so thank you for choosing us to host this today.
Well, thank you for the job you do for the Lawrence County students.
Absolutely.
We appreciate your dedication.
Thank you very much. I have with me now Trey Kemp, a county commissioner. Welcome, Mr. Kemp. Thank you for being here. Can you tell us what the Farm to Table initiative means to Lawrence County?
Sure. In education, we get so wrapped around the axle about behavior and acronyms and test scores and all these other things.
Yes.
But this is something that has a real impact on kids' lives day to day. It helps the children to receive nutrition they wouldn't otherwise receive, and it helps the local community to allow farmers to help those kids directly. And so that's a pretty big deal for us in Lawrence County, being as rural and as agrarian as we are. And I think it's something that is well run, and it's overdue.
Absolutely, and I know here at this school especially, we have numerous farms in our community, and we just are tickled that those local farms today are actually feeding students here.
That's
at our
right,
school. They're
exactly.
Actually on the menu today, so we're excited about that. So thank you for what you do. Thank you for being here today.
Thank you.
I have with me now Mr. Benjamin Newberry. He is from Macon, Bibb County. He's a local dairy farmer, and he supports this program and has provided. Tell us about it. Yeah. Tell us what you would want the parents to know about the product that you produce.
Well, we produce milk, and we're a dairy farmer, so we produce milk, and we believe that it is a healthy beverage that we produce not only for our family, but for the kids that are here as well, and the kids in the community that provides them with not only protein, but calcium and vitamin D, which they need to be healthy and to create a great learning mind.
Awesome. Well, thank you. And we know, working in a school with children, if they don't have those vital nutrients, they can't learn. And so
that's
thank
exactly
you for
right.
supporting what we do in our school.
You're very welcome. Thank you.
Thank you.